If you talk to any soldier that's been through a skirmish or a war, what they tell you, the only thing that saved their lives was either the man next to them or their training.
What came across in Georgia from a lot of the people was the strictness of the training that they receive, and how much they could rely on that when they get into the situation.
They say that until you've done something 2,500 times, you don't have the muscle memory. And that's what it is. They're counteracting human instincts. And that's why they train them so hard.
You know, they're trained to finish their mission and their objective. But just as important is to take care of your fellow Ranger.
They're very proud, the Rangers, of how their training worked and how these 19 and 20-year-old boys behaved on the day.
They had to cover each other, and they relied on their training. It's a testament to their training that any of them made it through at all.
For actors, we feel it's really important, if they're going to portray a military role, to actually be part of the military. So we try to put them through a boot camp, and not a Hollywood boot camp. We wanted the actors to have the respect for the military, what these kids go through, how they respect their officers, the physical torture that they go through, and feel a part of that. So when they're portraying their characters, they can draw on that. They also can draw on the tactics that they learned during this boot camp.
I'm a big believer in making sure that before we start shooting an action movie such as this one, that the weapon skills and the body motion, the body movement, the body language skills are taught up front, so we don't have to coach the actors so intensely on set. It serves no purpose in my mind to simply put these people through a harassing session up front to simply say, I've been through hell. What skills have you learned? That's my question. What do I have to teach you before you take this shot? The answer should be nothing, because we've already had it in a skill training session prior to shooting. Because of the intense support we're getting from DOD, I had three separate commands that stood up a training element. I had the 75th Ranger Regiment, Fort Benning, Georgia, stand up a training element to train our Rangers. Our actors actually went down to that command and went through a modified Ranger indoctrination program. And it was, without question, one of the finest training sessions I've ever seen any group of actors go through. Those actors playing the other unit, or the assault element, went through a training program in Fort Bragg. The 7th Special Forces group stood up a training A-team to teach those guys the skills required to portray their characters properly. The pilots actually went to Fort Campbell, Kentucky, where the SOAR, 160 SOAR, or TF-160 people, have their helicopter training program. So each of the commands that were there have had a shot at training the people portraying their characters. So it's unparalleled in any DOD training program that has ever been put forth before.
So we arrive at Fort Benning, and haircuts was the first thing.
I actually like this haircut. It's real quick. No messing around here.
Once you get the haircut, it all kind of comes together. It's all about the haircut.
You're gonna leave the eyebrows, right?
Oh yeah, we'll leave the eyebrows for you.
They have like hoovers on the end of the clippers so they don't lose any hair on the floor. It's just like vanity out the window, you're just gone. Okay, cool.
I've lost like a pound.
You talking to me? I don't see anybody else in my room.
Well,
you gotta be talking.
I feel myself transforming. Turning into a killing machine.
I just want mine thin and short, like a little mohawk, please.
The reason why I did this movie was because of the haircut. This haircut's mint. Oh, dude.
Yeah, I want like a fade.
I love having my head shaved. Yeah.
That doesn't bother me. It'll grow back, I hope.
Huh? Feel much better now, yes. Nice, clean haircut. Thank you.
R is for Ranger.
R is for Ranger.
A is for all the way.
A is for all the way.
It's not boot camp, it's Ranger orientation, and it was awesome.
We were quite strictly told that it was not boot camp, it was a Ranger orientation, because the training that we had was far less severe to the training that they have, I think was the idea, but it was a very good taste of what, you know, they go through.
Ranger! Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
We learned what it's like to be a Ranger, or to, what it's like to be a Ranger, you know. Because the Rangers really are very elite. They work really hard to become a Ranger. You've got to really want to be one.
I thought we were just playing normal soldiers. I didn't know we were playing actually elite soldiers who are, at, you know, in the top percentiles of the Army. So that was really intense.
Oh, yeah. All right. Oh, yeah.
Looking good.
Looking good.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
The Ranger orientation for the actors, the purpose of that was to give the actors a very quick snapshot of the tactics and techniques that Rangers use in ground fighting. Kind of give them a history of the Ranger Regiment, give them a detailed history of the Battle of Mogadishu and how the Rangers were involved in that, and then to show them how we do things so that when they are portraying us, it looks as realistic as possible.
The approach they took with us was to get us to know all about the mentality of Rangers, rather than the kind of taking us to the camp and kicking our ass.
I'm going to teach you four knots, right? These are the four knots you need to know to tie down your equipment properly. You're going to be the square knot, end of line full length, the cloak hitch, girth hitch, and the safety line, right? This is RBA, Ranger Body Armor. It's the first thing you're going to put on. If anyone wants to feel it before I put it on, come on up. Anyone want to feel it?
Yeah.
RBA itself weighs about 24 pounds. And your helmet weighs 4 pounds. Your weapon weighs 7 pounds. Thing is, you don't want your equipment just when you run and turn. If you have it real loose, it's going to just wrap around in front of you and, you know, it's going all over the place.
Ranger orientation was great. I wish it was 2 weeks instead of one. We only had 1 week.
We were up at 5:30, or out in the street, falling in at 6:10. We were moving over to the athletic field at 6:20.
We'd go for like a 3-mile run, and then we'd come back and we'd do press-ups, we'd do dips, we'd do everything.
We had class to educate us on everything from the proper technique of infiltrating a building and clearing a room to like weapons.
Weapons training, how to move, how to clear a room, understanding the chain of command, all of those things.
Basically, we did a lot of stuff on how to look like a Ranger.
But every day started out with what's called PT, which is physical training.
6!
1, 2, 3, 7!
1, 2, 3, 8!
1, 2, 3, 9!
1, 2, 3, 10!
1, 2, 3, 11!
1, 2, 3, 12!
1, 2, 3, 14!
Now the Rangers had boot camp. The Delta guys, we had fun.
Here's your body armor.
This is where you don't want to down.
This is not holster work time.
You don't want holster right there.
Let me just give you an example. I think the first day the Rangers were at Fort Benning, they were like, all right, this is the Ranger creed. The first day we were in Fort Bragg, they're going, see that door there? Let's blow it up. That started the week off. They stayed in barracks, we stayed in a Marriott. It was a whole other ball game.
There were only three of us at the Delta boot camp, and we had about 8 guys teaching us.
We were expecting just to be briefed and a lot of talking. Instead, what happened was that we
we got to do everything.
The first day that we were there, we began to work with weapons.
We want to keep a low profile, you know, so we're not bumping into walls and all of the other kinds of matter. So you're in like this. Cack-cack.
What you gotta do is let gravity work for you. Tuck it underneath your arm, hit your magazine release button, it'll fall straight out. Then you can tilt it. So if you tilt it first, you're not using gravity to get it out.
You go to the pistol.
In that week, it became very apparent how incredibly skilled and trained these young guys are. I mean, they're really drilled.
Try and walk from your knees down. Okay, you're gonna have some movement up here, but you're not. Okay, you see how I'm bouncing? Okay, now I'm keeping my knees together almost, making them knock against one another, and I'm walking light on my feet. See how I'm not bouncing anymore? Elbows tight in. You try and get from, you're like trying to walk a little sideways, okay? Try and keep from doing that. Try and keep your body square.
How they move, how they cover each other. I mean, they never sprint. You never sprint because you lose discipline. They move at a steady pace, covering each other, walking down the street.
They teach you a few little slogans like slow is smooth and smooth is fast. And that means, you know, just keep it, you know, keep it slow and smooth, you know, so that you can, because if you're bouncing around, you can't see everything.
You know what? We'll save your life. And then we'll save your life.
Right. Yeah. You're a little tense.
Be careful doing the side step so you're not tripping over yourself. I can already ID by right here, there's a threat right there, right? Uh-huh. Okay? Now, as I'm moving, I can be breaking down here, so I'm not doing this.
Clearing down the wall. There you go, good.
Okay, number two's right here on the hold. Yeah. Okay, got my weapon, boom. Okay, don't lose momentum, there you go. Don't move your head to the weapon, move the weapon to your head. We're turning around. Not too bad. Four.
Oh, where are you going?
You're getting shot.
I'm getting shot.
Please. Any criticism I give you here is constructive criticism. It's not meant to belittle you at all.
That's it. See how slow he went? Slow and smooth.
One of the interesting things about being in our boot camp was the idea that they instill a violence into the soldiers. They train them to deal with situations in a violent manner. As a non-military person, it took me by surprise that the natural fact, they teach them not only to take a building, but to take it with violence and force.
Violence of action is both mental and physical, okay? Both mental and physical. You use violence of action to gain or regain surprise. Make sense? You gotta tell yourself that you are the shit. You are the man, and nobody can mess with you, okay? That's the mental. The physical. Be aggressive.
It's quite a bizarre idea that occupied my mind for some time afterwards.
You've already got this cleared, so your rifle is more or less pointed right there.
Yeah.
It's clear if there's any problems, you're in too close with this wall to engage, you're going to have to just...
Yeah.
And then this guy just blows past you. You pin this guy up here, and then take out your knife and finish him off with your hatchet.
We're going to be working right up close with the explosives today. I mean, it's the real stuff, real McCoy. So just go step by step by what we tell you to do, and we're going to be right there with you. You know, don't do anything until we tell you to do it. If you have a question about something, you know, ask it. Because the first time you're wrong with demolitions could very well be the last time you're wrong with demolitions, okay? The whole idea of this charge, what we're doing here, we place it along the hinge side. You just start at the top. Place it up here as high as you can. Insert your thumbtacks in as best you can. Okay, and as I start pulling it down, see how I'm pulling the double stick tape?
I gather that most times that you'd be putting something on the door, there's a chance that somebody's behind it, you'd be very quiet about it.
Yeah, yes. You're as quiet as you can be, Bill.
As quiet as you can be. Now, once I get the charge all the way down on this, what I'll do is go ahead and prime it. Okay, just take my firing system and tie it on firmly. Everybody good?
Going hard on the breaching thing! Okay, so I remove the safeties. I just look real quick. Gotcha. Let's go. Crouch down. Keep an eye on the charge. Watch me.
I was able to go down to Fort Campbell, where the 160th is. I met about 13 of the Little Bird pilots, the smaller helicopter pilots. I met Mike Durant.
I'm Mike Durant, and we met briefly for the first time over at the simulator today. Retired recently as CW4. I was a flight lead of the Ranger Element, pilot in command of Super 6-4. The briefing that you're going to see today is really a macro-level briefing, and hopefully I'm not insulting what you know about the overall mission, but I've given this thing probably hundreds of times at this point, and there has been 7 years that have gone by, and not everybody knows all these facts, and if they did know them at one time, they may have forgotten them. So this really rolls it all up into one, from the time the U.S. got involved, really taking it all the way through till the withdrawal, the release of some of the folks that were apprehended by Task Force Ranger, that kind of stuff.
I was surprised by how moved I was by meeting these guys. They were so not chest out and macho guys. They were all very calm, very relaxed, very professional. And then when they started telling their stories, it was a bit shocking.
Gary Gordon went down first. He went down on the left side of the aircraft, but I have no idea under what circumstances. All I know is I heard him say something to lead me to believe that he had been hit, like, damn, I'm hit, or something like that. I never saw him again. Well, now, any sense of comfort I might have had thinking a rescue force is there is now gone. I've only seen two guys. One of them's down. Now, this one's out of ammunition, possibly, if he's asking for more weapons. We are in dire straits. I had run out of ammunition. I'd placed my weapon across my chest, looking up at the sky, assuming that it was over. I mean, there's nothing you could do.
We got to meet a lot of the people that we would be playing.
And they were there because they'd chosen to come and talk to us about it and answer questions, and they ended up staying the evening and we had a few beers. It was incredibly useful and interesting and helpful.
Right. If there's any time we start feeling fear, is that next morning, because there was almost a slight sense of panic because things weren't right. Like, this is the Ranger Regiment. We're the most funded, we're the best unit in the world, and here we are running out of this town on foot. Right. Why? How is this happening? And that was the kind of mentality, and it was just like, shoot and go and just pray to God a bullet and hit you run across.
People were bounding properly, they weren't just running.
We were bounding properly, but right. You just got the sense that at any second, because our training was good and everybody was in great shape, it held together. But I really did feel like that next morning, and that's how I get through anything in military training or got through it, was just, I just know that you rely on the training. The training's the equipment, the training, and the guy next to you is going to pull you through it.
I think this is McKnight's piece, actually.
Good God.
These are the bullet holes that came through the front.
Good God. What's this in?
That's an ammo box. This is the strap that the gunner would sit on up top.
Uh-huh. So he's free, really?
Yeah.
And he can swing around?
He can swing all the way around, exactly.
When we got back to the stadium, there was a lot of the 10th Mountain men who had come in to help get us out. We're over there, you know, in the neighborhood. And this was Somalia, and I remember feeling cold. You know, I think I had spent so much adrenaline, and I was shaking. They were giving us hot tea and coffee, and it was like 70 degrees outside. And all of us were just sort of standing around, and then we got together and we started getting the damage report and find out who we lost. And it was kind of a shocker.
The simulator is unbelievable. It's like flying a helicopter. So you really go through the paces of what they had to go through.
It's tricky I still can't quite figure out if I have to give it, oh wow, that's very cool. I suddenly saw a helicopter fly underneath me there, and I started going towards it. Oh, I just killed us. Damn. How did I do that?
for the safety of everyone involved, I never flew one of these helicopters because I don't know how to fly a helicopter. You know, it's pretty intense stuff. All your motor skills are needed at every moment, but it's the hardest thing you've ever kind of witnessed because it's a push and pull at all times, and it's so completely delicate. Everything, it's so responsive.
No, I can't do anything with my feet though, right?
Oh. Okay, board collected. Board collected. All the way down. Level aircraft. Okay, now we're in off rotation.
Okay.
Notice I have to zoom down. We're in off rotation. Coming to the ground.
And now, pull up. Oh. Oh, hold on now. Oh, no, we're in trouble.
Now you're crashing.
Oh, we're dead. Yeah. Damn.
Stats. One up.
Two up.
Three up. Four up. Church left. Got you covered.
I don't know if Harry was in your way or what. The main thing is just keep going. Like I said, even if you fuck it up, fuck up aggressively.
Yeah.
Me, that's my war wound. I'm the main instructor, and I teach you guys stairwell hallways. Tuck down a ranger.
Oh, come on, man.
You know, people were kind of dropping like flies. I think like, and I was one of the flies, I'm afraid to say.
The actors aren't rangers, and we realized that after about day one. But they did a great job. They came together as a team towards the end there, and maintained their motivation. We threw some things at them that were physically and mentally demanding, and they did a great job.
We basically worked towards being able at the end of the week to travel through a street theoretically under fire like a group of trained rangers.
In Somalia, although they were under fire, they got a call. Hey, you need to get your platoon from this end of the city to the other end of the city. All right? And that's what we're going to talk about, just moving through a city. In a non-permissive environment where you may take fire at any moment, you want to get through that pretty quickly, as quickly as you can, because speed is your security to an extent here.
Go.
Go.
Some stuff at the end in a mock-up street, village type thing, where we had to work our way down the street and avoid being shot. I got shot, of course, and take out, you know, the people who were shooting at us. So like a mock-up battle situation. And I wished we'd spend the week doing that, because that's what would have been most relevant for this film.
At the end of the week, we had a mock Black Hawk Down situation.
They took us into a cinder block city. And this was the amazing part of it all. To get to this, where they said, okay, you're gonna start off here, you're gonna fast rope off that building, you're gonna go in here. There will be doors in there. If there's a yellow marker on the door, a single one, you're gonna shotgun it. If there are two, you're gonna blow that door. You're gonna move through there. There might be people in there. If there are people in there, flex cuff them, you gotta take them out. Live people.
And then supposedly a helicopter had been shot down and we had to get from A to B, and in between were all these rangers who were more than willing to shoot at us.
So exhausted in my life. It was like 50 minutes. It was amazing.
Because all I could think of was when I took my helmet off and had all that heavy gear, was that was only an hour and a half or 2 hours, and these guys were there for 30 or 36. That was the first thing that hit me, was just how physically demanding it would be.
Almost more important than all the training is the creed that they live by. It's like a religion.
We thought that it was an unwritten rule that you didn't leave a man behind. It turns out it's a written rule. There's a thing called the Ranger Creed, which is six stanzas that they recite every morning en masse.
First stanza of the Ranger Creed, repeat after me. Recognizing I volunteer as a ranger.
Recognize I volunteer as a ranger.
Fully knowing the hazards of my chosen profession.
Fully knowing the hazards of my chosen profession.
I'll always endeavor.
To uphold the prestige.
Honor.
And
high spirit of corps.
And high spirit of corps.
For my ranger regiment.
The basic center is that you never leave a ranger behind. And that is paramount. I mean, that is drilled into them from the word go, you know, over and above their weapons training, everything else is it's a kind of way of life.
The Night Stalkers' motto is NSDQ. Night Stalkers don't quit. You never quit. The Rangers, you never leave a man behind.
They wanted to explain that to us and drill it into us more than they wanted to teach us how to hold a gun.
Acknowledging the fact that a ranger is a more elite soldier. Who arrives at the cutting edge of battle.
My land.
Sea.
Or air.
I accept the fact.
That as a ranger.
My country has picked me.
To move further.
Faster. And fight harder.
They become brothers, and they depend on each other. You know, the man on your shoulder is the man covering you, is the man who can save your life as much as you can save theirs. You don't come across that kind of relationship every day.
They have this mindset of your back is covered by your ranger buddy's back. You watch your ranger buddy's back. You don't think about your own, you think about everyone else's. Therefore, if everyone thinks like that, everyone's back should be covered.
Never shall I fail my comrades!
Never shall I fail my comrades!
I always keep myself mentally alert!
Physically strong!
And morally straight!
And I'll show more than my share of the task!
Whatever it may be!
100%! And then some!
It's like having, 200 best friends. But even more so, that will die for you. I would be lying if I said I knew what that meant. Because I really don't. I can get close to it, but I don't really know that I would have it in me to die for somebody, you know.
Gallantly will I show the world.
And I'm a specially selected, well-trained soldier.
My courtesy to your officer.
In this address.
And care of equipment!
Shall set the examples for others to follow!
Certainly you get a brotherhood when you go to boot camp and you do those kind of things that we did.
We all pushed ourselves beyond our physical limits. And there's a camaraderie and a support network that comes from having seen everybody dropping from exhaustion or feeling like they can't go on and dragging them forward.
It was a real sense of coming together for the cause because we knew we couldn't get through it without helping each other.
Energetically, I'll meet the enemies of my country.
I
shall defeat them on the field of battle.
We'll fight with all my might.
Surrender is not a ranger word. I'll never leave a fallen comrade. To fall into the hands of the enemy. Will I ever embarrass my country?
These are real characters. You know, this is a real guy. This is a real man I'm portraying. And we just want to bring integrity to it and, a lot of respect.
On the last day of boot camp, we all got an anonymous note pushed under our door that thanked us for our hard work and asked us to tell their story true. And it was signed from all the boys who died. And it was one of the most moving experiences of the week.
I left there with a lot of respect. For not only the Rangers, but everybody who serves for our country. And it made me work harder as an actor to portray these guys correctly and as accurately as possible.
Bradley Wild is playing!
It's
tested for 2 to 4!
It's tested for